everybody. This is Randall. Out on the tractor again. Want to shoot a video, show you how good this little old Kubota tractor does. It's a dandy little old tractor. I moved some big rocks, I moved some big trees, and I'll just put this thing through the mill. I laid out that spot for the camper shed with it, leveled everything out within about 2 inches, I guess. Put gravel down, spread probably 5 or 6 loads of 30 tons each of gravel, and it moves some huge rocks. I just want to show you the big rock, that flat rock that I moved the other day. I dug out of the ground with it. Look. See that big rock over on the other side, that big flat rock? I moved it. I put all these flat rocks in the tree before I could come across it to the tractor. Without getting marred up, I want to put some extra ones out here. At least I'll try to mar up on this side coming back up. It did pretty good. See, there's a bigger, better picture of that flat rock right there. See that big flat rock? I dug that some gun out of the ground with this tractor the other day. I got the tiller on the back of this thing now, tilling these gardens up. Time to plant gardens before long. We're gonna have to till them up where we can get some groceries to eat and something to feed the chicken. We got this out here. This is wheat and rye. We'll get it up sometime this year. We'll be able to feed the chickens through the winter. This little old tractor's been a good one. I bought this and a front loader and a bush hog. I didn't get the trailer with it. But I bought a disc and a plow. And I bought this tiller to go on the back of it. I'll show you this tiller. There's a guy in Kentucky I bought this tiller from. I gave him $1,000 for it, but I don't know. I guess it was worth it. Hopefully it was. It's a dandy little tiller though. I got that shade there, it was green. They sent me a green one instead of the orange. I ordered an orange one, they sent me a green one. I guess they run out of them or something. I didn't really care what color it was as long as it kept the rain off my head, kept the sun from beating down on me all day long. pretty girls there, isn't it? That field over there, Nick, on the other side of the bend where I bush hogged the other day. But I tell you, this tractor here is probably one of the best you can buy, I guess. I don't know, I never drove a John Deere. I never had a John Deere. I had some old Ford tractors. But I'll tell you what, for a compact size, this little old tractor sure puts out some work. It's a B2501. They make another one a little smaller with smaller tires on the back. About the same size of a front loader. But this one has got a pretty good bit of power. But I wouldn't want to go no lower. Matter of fact, I'd like to get a bigger one later on. Because it's just a little lighter than what I need. I need one a little bigger where I can bale hay and stuff with it. But it's got this little three-cylinder diesel, and it'll run all day on a tank of gas, bush hogging, and still have plenty enough left over. I knocked them trees there the rest of the way down the other day, cut them up, carried around the fence there, closed them gaps up. I probably need to move some more stuff around to fill these gaps up around here where I can keep people from coming in here and hunting. We found a place where somebody's been hunting here on the back side. I don't know who it was, but it looked like it's been a long time since that stand has been used. But somebody built a metal ladder and a stand up here. But I may try to revamp it, fix it up, hunt down here myself. There's also a big creek back here in the back, right past that rock wall fence down there. You see that rock wall fence? I'm just wondering if there's any good fish in there. They might be, I don't know. But they places all down through there where I can get through there and fish or the fence down. I gotta go up there and get a rope I left on these trees the other day. I left the rope on when I was pulling in. That rope broke on me on that one tree. I had to go get my chain and get it finished dragging it over. This is that field of bush hog. My bush hog blades are sort of dull, but this field has been growing up for like 3 years. It hadn't been bush hog. I was cutting cedar trees down as tall as my knee that had grown up in it. And there were briars everywhere, man. Them old, I guess they blackberry briars or something, trying to grow. But that won't happen again, because I'm gonna keep this bush hog. As soon as I get that blade sharpened up on that bush hog, I'm gonna go back over it. But man, it's greened up quite a bit since I bush hog, it just looked like it was all just dead. It was ugly, ugly looking. They rocked all over. That guy wouldn't even attempt to try to do any row cropping on this. That guy may have got that rope on there. Oh, it's still on there. Cutting out a little every now and then.